Up, winning his 54th cap tonight for his country, the Socceroo skipper says he wants to get to 75 and perhaps more. Fallon. That's with Elliott. Bertos couldn't get there first. Used the body well though there, Leo Bertos. Hold off Carney. Knocked on by Smells. Chance for New Zealand and they've scored, the Kiwis. It's Chris Killen. Of an hour played and he ghosted in at the far stick, and Chris Killen sends those all-white supporters into raptures at the MCG.
Well, he's ghosted in at the back post, comes in around the back of Milligan. It really was a nothing ball in from Simon Elliott from a good area, touched on by Schmelz, and Killen just around the back of Milligan, just slightly too late. Little chip in here from Elliott. Schmelz with the flick on, and Killen really with the easiest of tasks as he guides this one. It touches Federici, and it goes into the bottom right-hand corner of the net. Well, the warning sign was there just before. They've made the best two chances of the game, and they've now scored one.
Goals have been a problem, though, for the Green and Golds. Just seven in the last six internationals. Five of those were scored by defenders. Two with McDonald's, slightly overran it, it's broken kindly for Vidicic. Dario Vidicic ties it up at 1-1 with his first international goal. What a moment for Dario Vidicic.
We go low and hard across the keeper, you've always got a chance. It's a somewhat of a lucky goal for Australia because it's a bit of a ricochet, but he finds himself really on the edge of the 6-yard box. On his own, goes across the keeper into the far right-hand corner of the net. And Australia, who built up a bit of momentum, there's a good run from Kalina. It's a little 1-2 with Scott McDonald. There's the run from Vidicic. He's clearly onside. It's a ricochet. It's not a pass. And he smashes that one into the ground, and the bounce takes it over Paston. The positive run from Kalina. There's the lucky ricochet that takes it to Vidicic, and Australia back on level terms.
Well, credit to Vidicic. It was a tough angle. He had to keep the ball down first of all. And he's managed to find the back of the net. Don't forget, this isn't quite Australia's last hit out before the World Cup starts. Denmark and the USA to come in friendlies over in South Africa. We'll see them both live and exclusive here on Fox Sports. June the 1st and June the 5th, respectively.
Not the last two hit-outs.
So it's Carney. It's Australia look for a late winner. Squared up for Carl Valeri. Little sandwich over the top, and Holman! It's there! Brad Holman has scored for Australia and probably won the game for Australia with just his second international goal and his first for 3 years.
Well, that's certainly broken New Zealand hearts, and to be honest, they probably don't deserve it. But Brett Holman won't care. And the Socceroos don't care. It was pressure, it was Carney on the left-hand side. Instead of going down the outside like he normally does, he cuts inside. He lays this one off. That was Holman that laid it off first, and he's just drifted in behind. They get caught ball watching the New Zealand defence. And Holman, gee, that's a good finish. Nice and cool. It's coming from a fair old height. And he just side foots that into the back of the net. Across the keeper again. You've always got a chance when you do that. That's a very good finish. That's a little ball, the little dink over the top.
And it proves to be the last kick of the game, would you believe it? Brett Holman in desperate need of a goal, as Scott McDonald was tonight, but unlike the Middlesbrough striker, Brett Holman gets one.
Of course, a lot easier to accept that approach at World Cup level when you're against bigger reputations, deeper football cultures, with more proven track records. Denmark, although they've only been to one World Cup finals more, certainly are a team that play to dominate.
Here's Kullenberg, who certainly dominated David Carney on that occasion. Craig Moore is perfectly positioned on the edge of the six-yard box. Now Kalina can perhaps set up a counter for Australia. Wilkshire is on the right. Supported behind from Valeri and now Grella. Space for Bresciano. Holman and Kennedy further forward. Wilkshire with the angle to try and cross, takes a deflection, awkward bounce, Kennedy might get there, he drops for Josh Kennedy, and he walks it into the back of the net, and Australia have the lead with 20 minutes to go. A soft goal from Denmark's perspective, but Australia don't care, they lead, and it's big Josh on the mark.
The Denmark's defence in the first instance beaten by the ball's flight, and the second beaten by the rangy frame of Josh Kennedy, who hooked the ball past Stefan Andersen, gives Australia the lead. It was a good situation they'd built for themselves. Out of defence they moved, Kalina bursting from centre midfield to right flank, Luke Wilkshire finding him, and a matter of four or five passes later, Grella, Bresciano, etc. The ball happened to find Josh Kennedy, to the deflection off Luke Wilkshire's cross. It was the flight and then the bounce and then the muscularity and then the reaction of Josh Kennedy. And Australia get the lead. Daniel Agger beaten, Stefan Andersen beaten. Australia in front.
Josh Kennedy's seventh goal for his country. He has been on fire for his club side, Nagoya Grampus. This is Carlos Bocanegra. And he's picked out Landon Donovan on the far post, who just got a metre on Scott Chipperfield. Good direction on the header, not enough power. Now, Vince Grella has been caught in possession, and the US could be in here. This is Edson Buddle, who fires the Americans into the lead after just 3 minutes. A super finish, but a dreadful error by Vince Grella, and the Socceroos have gifted the Americans a goal in the opening minutes.
Well, it's a goal born and bred in the United States and developed in Major League Soccer with LA Galaxy, Edson Buddle just tripping through the Australian defence as Vince Grella coughed up possession. From that range and from that angle, Mark Schwarzer with very little chance. And he didn't muck around, Buddle. He smashed it right into the heart of Australia's goal.
It's his first international goal in just his third cap. He was a bit of a surprise choice by American coach Bob Bradley, but he has given the Americans the lead. It's an outstanding first 13 and a half minutes or so in the white jersey of the United States. Capped with his first international goal. This is Bocanegra, who slips it through, and there's no offside flag. Robbie Finlay is in here. It could be 2-0. He's round Schwarzer. Oh, he's put it wide. Incredible, he did all the hard work, Robbie Finlay, and then blazed it wide of the target. Australia should be two goals down.
Well, he just lost his balance terribly there. Lucas Neal is adamant that should have been called offside. It's waved as play on. He gets rid of Mark Schwarzer with ease and then loses his balance. Does Finlay. Australia caught Denmark offside on a number of occasions on Tuesday. And Australia a chance from a set tee, so it's a better phase of play by Australia. And over the first 18 and a half minutes, you'd have to say that in the centre of the park is where Australia has completely controlled things, which has led to their short-term demise.
Decent corner, and Australia have the equaliser through Tim Cahill.
Very short
term. It's a super volley.
A very short-term demise, Tim Cahill. Not for the first time, anticipating throwing himself athletically with a crisp contact, and Australia draw level. Tim Howard couldn't have had anything, any chance to stop his Everton teammate. And now that Tim Cahill has scored, will Australia's record under that continue? They've never lost in a game in which Tim Cahill has scored, and have drawn level here in Johannesburg.
40 caps, 20 goals for Tim Cahill, and it was a super finish. Awkward on the half volley. He managed to find the gap past his Everton teammate Tim Howard. So we're back all square. Touch off the head of Vince Grella. 45th cap tonight for the Blackburn Rovers midfielder. Interest were told from Turkey in his services, in the shape of Galatasaray, to Socceroos already there, Lucas Neal and Harry Kuehl, of course. Chirundolo with the centre, free header, and it's 2-1 for the Americans, and it's a second goal for Edson Buddle.
Well, that's too easy, really. Chirundolo did very well down the right-hand side, but he really just dropped a shoulder, a step over, and then he was away. Bresciano beaten. The cross was a peach. But there were plenty of gold shirts, plus Mark Schwarzer, patrolling the goal. That's a delightful cross. Wiltshire just the wrong side of his man. Craig Moore beaten in flight. Schwarzer beaten as the last line, and Buddle gets a brace.
Well, it's not often that Australia cop two goals in a game, but Edson Buddle has breached the Socceroo backline twice in the opening half an hour. And Rumsick managed to thread it through two pairs of legs to find Josh Kennedy. Now Luke Wiltshire. Chip to the far stick. Cahill leaps. Chipperfield picks up the pieces. Back in, and Josh Kennedy has missed from point-blank range.
Well, it's turning into quite the shootout here at Rumsick. Switch of play, which is rescued by Cahill. Chipperfield, where he loves to be in attacking areas, and talk about nice touch on the cross. And even on that one, from that angle, you could see the ball just take that last minute swerve. Perhaps that was too much for Josh Kennedy in the end, heading wide. A great chance for Australia again to draw the World Cup. And Buddle proving that one wrong in the first half with his second goal.
This is Landon Donovan, who slips it through, and there's no offside flag. Edson Buddle in for a hat-trick. It's off the frame of the goal. Michael Bradley, Schwarzer with the save, and eventually the Americans do have a third goal, or do they? No, the flag's been raised.
Offside.
Well, it was like pinball back there in the Australian penalty box. Mark Schwarzer at full tilt trying to keep the ball out. The Americans thought they had a third, but they've been denied by that man.
Well, irrespective of the goal going in or not, it was the concern again with which the United States opened up Australia's defence. Schwartz's reaction's brilliant. And another warning for Australia. Tim Verbeek isn't scratching any more notes on that, the back of that envelope, but his mind is absorbing, his eyes are perusing. He's filing through his experience coaching background to work out the solutions. There's Buddle looking to square the ball. It's the crossbar that saves Australia in the first instance. And you know what, there's a fair case for that being play on. It'll be like thoroughbred race. Players will lift their performance after a taper, will go up a cog or two.
Donovan, back heel by Findlay, touch by Clark, back to Donovan, he's going to drive it low, and that seals the victory for the Americans.